Steelhead, have people looked at Steelhead? Or fish for Steelhead? Those are Steelhead and Rainbow are the same species. But Steelhead will come back, so they tend not to be in the upper reaches of watersheds. So for them, it was okay to do a rainbow-like history and spawn once and then go back to the ocean. So they don't all die. But they also get big, so they have the benefits of growth. So the way they think the evolution worked was originally that they were trout that were freshwater. You started going to the ocean, got bigger, and that was a large benefit for those groups, and then they became a kind of salmon. Some of them stayed as freshwater species, like cutthroats, rainbows. And then what they think happened is that the steelhead are a more recent evolutionary stage of rainbows. So you have almost all the combinations of completely sea-run, where these guys are so hardwired into a sea run strategy that even if you take away the access to the ocean, they still evolutionarily are working like there is an ocean out there that they can go to. To things like rainbow that are spawning all the time. All these fish are kind of evolved from a group of fish that were in the Pacific Northwest, so rainbows are endemic to Northern California and various other places. With these fish, it's not quite so apparent because the run sizes aren't super big, although 5,000 of these fish coming up here. You could imagine that this is one of the few kinds of things where nutrients move upstream in a watershed. Normally, everything moves downstream with the water, but these fish are moving it back. So the chapter of the section we read out of diary of
View from Lazy Point
kind of just talks a little bit about that uniqueness of animals bringing nutrients from the ocean. When we have Redfish Lake, we're actually able to measure the ocean nitrogen in the trees, and so you can take leaves of a tree, grind it up, and measure the kind of nitrogen, and that nitrogen ends up being enriched in N15, and it turns out that in Redfish Lake, about 15% of the nitrogen comes back from the ocean. It's in Redfish. You can't really do that here because the nitrogen's the same. Which are, you know, it's basically it's freshwater nitrogen. The fish don't really pick up any. So we'll go grab a couple of nets and try to catch some of these. Do people have any questions about the general life history and that sort of thing? We'll have to bring back some fish for Erica. So in the back of the